I grew up around art my whole life. Both my parents are artists. In fact, my father was the founding chair of the art department at UCF. Well, what he tried to teach me was to not go into the arts, and it just didn't stick, apparently. I'm interested in working with young artists, helping them sort of push their own boundaries. But it's also a thrill to work with, you know, the people that you read about in magazines and the textbooks.
So this is a woodcut that we did with James Sienna. Every one of these directional changes in the image is a different piece of lumber.
The way I think of it is it's a research space. So an artist will come here with maybe a half an idea or maybe no ideas, and through a dialogue about what I know about their work and their process and what equipment and techniques that we have expertise in, something usually comes together. At least a general idea of a direction in which to go becomes apparent, and then, you know, we'll try a couple things, and that looks like it has value, we keep going. If not, then we go a different tack. But it's sort of a dance, you know, with these people when they come in, what works. Flying Horse serves as a visiting artist program for the greater university. We have the interns and students, art students and work study students, work side by side with the artists on some of these techniques. A lot of them are very technical and labor intensive, and the artists themselves really don't know those techniques. So it's an opportunity for our art students to, you know, really see the process of an established working artist. So we're supported by members, which are collectors from the community that want to support our mission of promoting the arts in the area. And for the membership fee, they get 3 projects that we produce in the year. So sometimes that's a print, sometimes it could be an edition piece of sculpture, sometimes it could be a limited edition artist book. I think what brings everybody together is this common goal. We're trying to get the best work out of the artist, and the artist wants to do the best work, so we're all sort of a support staff to helping the artist come to, you know, to do the best work.
It was very hard for us to contemplate leaving our old studio. We, you know, it just had such great history. You know, great artists had made really fantastic work there over the last 10 years. So it was heartbreaking to get the news that, we might need to move. But this new space is actually just going to be so much better.
Flying Horse is at a place of growth that we're being recognized on a national level. It's exciting that the new space is happening at the same time.
The public will be able to peer into the space and see us working, seeing the artists work. It's got a great gallery space, which you'll be able to see it as you drive or walk by. In the old space, we had taken over rooms around the building for particular processes. And in this new space, it's all under one roof, one continuous space. We know more about how we work than we did when we designed the first space, so this is just much more efficient. Really designed to be a state-of-the-art, collaborative, creative research space.
We always dreamed of this day, that Flying Horse would get here, would work with these sort of artists, that we would have the visibility and reputation on a national level to attract major collectors, institutions, individuals that support the process, and we're here. And at the same time, we have a beautiful new space for these artists to work in.
I think one of the great things about the Flying Horse program is how students are able to plug into that. It really gives them insight into different creative processes and creative methods.
Flying Horse Editions is a dynamic atmosphere where the collaboration takes place with the artists, students, community members, and faculty. And to see that at work is really, really special.
The Jaffe collection was given to FAU in 1998. The original gift was 2,800 books. We're now up to 12,000. So we needed space, and we've changed the mission to a large extent. Much more hands-on, much more exhibitory, much more museum quality than collection quality. And I think that's what you get when you come in. It's more of a feeling of a museum and lecture hall than it is a book collection. In considering the new space for the Book Arts Center, it was a question of what do we do with the original space here? And what we did, and it turned out to be perfect, we made that into a print shop for printing presses. We got gifts given to us of old printing presses, and now we've got the most beautiful print shop in all of Florida, so we have been told.
Arthur has transformed this collection from a simple collection of books into the Jaffe Center for Book Arts, combining the features of an art gallery, a letterpress studio, and a teaching venue. In the process, he's brought something totally unique to Florida Atlantic University, and we're so fortunate to have had his collection and his presence for so long a time.
If I were buying books just about architecture, then I would have a limitation. I'm buying eclectically. I'm interested in the whole world, and I just don't know what's out there myself. When somebody brings it in there, I see the light and say, boy, I think this can be useful. What does this thing say? I don't know what it says, but I like what it looks, you know. The search process, I'm at a point in life here at this collection where the book artists are looking for us. And that's part of the fun of having the collection, having a collection like this. You meet the most interesting people in the world from everywhere. And they come from out of nowhere and appear at your front door and say, I've made a book. I want you to see it. And of course, we want to see it. And that's how we get most of our books. Andrew Binder came in, strolling in one day and with a rather large book under his arm, saying this is his latest production of books. And he wanted to show it to me. He opened it up and I said, Andrew, you've got a winner here. And he had just come back from 4 years off and on going to Thailand to produce a book, a pop-up, about the Thai temples. And it's now in the Jaffe collection. It's one of a kind. Only one in the world is here. So I proudly show it, and everybody likes to see it. It's a very dramatic book. Listen, the book isn't just to be read. It's to be touched. It's to be heard. It's to be manipulated like you do with a book that's pop-up. You have to do manipulation. So there's just a lot more variety in what we're doing with the book today.
Arthur's legacy is such a strange paradox, and to me it is that is the most intriguing thing about the Jaffe Center. Our focus is certainly on the traditions of the book arts, and these are the things that brought humanity into the information age. But nowadays we can get our information electronically, and the book itself as an information vehicle is not quite as important as it used to be. But Arthur's collection focuses equally on the artist's book. And when artists make books, they tend to be nothing at all what we expect a book to be. And this is where we get to the future of the book. It's these books that tend to expand our vision, expand our ideas, expand our creativity. And that, to me, is what's really the most wonderful thing about Arthur's legacy. It's certainly rooted in the past, but looking to the future for sure.
This is a way of life. Reading is a way of life.
Arthur collects the soul of this world when he looks for books. It's not an academic library. It's not math. It's not science. It's the things that fall in between the words that Arthur always captures, that he finds, the emotion, the spirit. And that's the heart of his collection. He finds the heart of the world.
I don't really want people to remember me particularly. It doesn't matter. I want them to remember the collection and say, that's a hell of a collection, and that's all that counts. And I think that's true of everything in life, you know. I'm here, I'm gone, I've done my best. And if I've left something behind that other people can enjoy, I think I've been very successful. There's a saying, be ashamed to die until you have some victory for humanity. That's my motto.
Welcome to Ground Printmaking. I am Kim Spivey, and I want to share with you my artist-run press. I am an artist with a BFA degree in printmaking and an MFA degree in painting. Ground Printmaking was started in 2017 as a place where artists could explore the medium of printmaking with a focus on a greener approach to etching. Special consideration is given to the materials used to ensure a healthy and safe environment to work in, as historically many toxic substances have been used in the creation of making prints. Coming to printmaking from another medium, an artist enters a space that allows for a different pathway to create, that perhaps might bring up something new in the way that they approach their work going forward. There is a magical component when a print is pulled off the press for the first time. Within etching alone, there are so many factors that can affect the outcome of the print. And to explore these, many tests are made to visualize a range of possibilities. A big part of ground printmaking is education and sharing the processes of safer printmaking. In demonstrations, observers are walked through the entire etching process and walk away with an understanding of what an original print is and the processes behind making one. In a screen-dominant world, there is something to experiencing an original print in person and taking in all the subtleties and micro-typographies from the ink and pressure. I have opened my artist-run press to South Florida artists and community members who want to explore their creativity in a new medium. I delight in working with a wide range of people with a broad range of goals. I always learn something new in each encounter and have decided that outreach and education through safer printmaking practices is the mission of my artist-run press. Inspired by these exchanges, I find my own work is revitalized and that it provides for a sustainable practice. Ground Printmaking is located in Palm Beach Gardens, and you can visit my website www.kimspivey.com for more information.
Thank you. Hi, my name's Ingrid Schindel, and this is my fine art printmaking studio, IS Projects, here in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Due to the recent COVID-19 pandemic, we've actually had to close our doors for a good while now, and we're uncertain as to when it'll be safe to reopen. So, my team and I have spent the last month focused on learning new online platforms and figuring out ways in which we can utilize these platforms to best suit our audience and their needs. Our favorite time of month is the Fat Village Art Walk, where we get to meet new people and connect with some of our old pals here in the studio. With Art Walk suspended until it's safe to gather again, we've put together a virtual studio tour where you can check out the studio, see some of the products that we make here, as well as learn about the presses and equipment that we use here in the studio. Through the virtual studio tour, you can also check out our virtual gallery, where you can see the exhibition, check out details of the pieces on display, and purchase artworks to help support the artists in the exhibition as well as the studio. Art Walk is the last Saturday of the month from 6 to 10 p.m., and during that time, we'll be hosting live Instagram programming, including an artist talk with the artists featured in the gallery.
Hi, my name is Sammy McLean, and I'm the gallery and workshop coordinator here at IS Projects. We're really excited to be debuting some virtual classes so that people can participate in printmaking and book art online. We're starting with a paper marbling class, a drum leaf bookbinding class, and then really focusing on classes that don't require too much specialty materials or equipment, things that you can easily source. I think people will get to interact in an interesting way in the Zoom meetings. If you're somebody that wants to be a little bit more anonymous, you know, it allows you to do that. But then you can, of course, interact with a lot more people. And in that setting, we're able to have more people included in the workshop than we would if we're limited on physical space.
I want to thank everyone who's been following along with our journey on social media and reaching out to check in during this crisis. It means so much to have your support. We miss you. Can't wait to see you.
Tom Virgin is a Miami-based artist, proprietor of Extra Virgin Press, and for 25 years, a Title I public school art teacher. His printmaking workshop, Extra Virgin Press, was founded as a community letterpress in 2015 with support from many partners. The mission of Extra Virgin Press is to help preserve the art of letterpress printing in Miami through teaching, printing, and bringing together a variety of community voices, including youth and the literary and artistic residents of Miami.
So, I'm gonna show you how that thing works, because the one thing that made it possible for me to have a press was someone who knew me and was my teacher and talked to me and found out that I wanted to print, but I wanted to print for me, and I wanted to print for all my communities. And I have a lot of communities. So this is a challenge proof press, and this is a letterpress print being pulled. And this is a quote that was one of the quotes that I collected by Audre Lorde, who also is upcoming in another Ulay Arts book. And just in case you didn't see that, the cool thing about this is you can make a bunch. One more. So many people have worked with me to make these things with wood type, with words, with ideas, with literature, with complaints, with music, with communities. And these guys are the guys that make me do this, the people that love art enough to make it possible for other people to bring it home. And people who feel like not saying anything is worse than complaining. So I wish that I could say I'd answer all your questions. I can try to see if I can get through these. But you guys probably want to go eat dinner and do something else. There's lots of good things happening in this world. Come by and smell the ink one day. And when this is done, we'll print something. The presses do the work. I turn the crank. I'm the printer. These are the presses. And you guys are the reason why I print. Thank you so much.